Hey everybody, welcome to Workforce Gaming. I am Brad, along here with Doug.
Hi.
This was the night that everybody was waiting for. Well, yesterday night was. So just to put this in kind of a time space, because there's been crazy amounts of stuff coming out all over the place the past 24 hours or so. We are recording this on January 13th, late afternoon. So as information kind of comes out, this may get to be very obsolete very quickly, but the Switch is a thing and it's real, and we know when it's coming out, we know how much it costs, we know what the games are, and yeah, that happened.
Yeah, no, I mean, I think that's like a long time coming. I think it was nice to, I'm so glad, like, there's no, you don't have to deal with any rumors anymore of like, what is this thing, what are the games coming out. It's like, well, no, here is what it is.
Yep.
Yeah.
Because you're right. It was one of those things where it's a long time coming, where this is a very different game system launch than what we've seen before, where it's, I mean, essentially, what was it? It was October, so like 6 months out, you just get a 3-minute trailer, and then less than 2 months out, they actually tell you what it is. I mean, I feel like we knew what the PS4 was a year in advance.
Yeah.
I mean, they announced Scorpio almost, 8 or 9 months now. It doesn't come out for all we know for another 12 months. So It's very interesting. It's a very different strategy, which I'll be curious to see how that pays off in the long run. But just to start throwing the information out there, they started right away last night with March 3rd, which is less than 2 months, which seems super ridiculous to me. Like, that seems way too fast.
Yeah, and they kind of proved that. And like, yeah, I honestly was surprised. I was like, that is less than 2 months away. That was like actually shocking to me. I didn't think it'd be coming out that fast. So my thought was like, holy crap, there are going to be so many games for this thing when it launches, because they must be super confident in it. When I came away from this conference at the end, I was like, the hardware has been done for a while. They're still working on the games. So.
Yeah, this feels like, this really did feel like we had to build these games for this system because we didn't want to run into a Wii U issue. And we might talk about that later. We'll get into the launch lineup and everything like that, or what it is as of again today. But it definitely feels like them going like, as soon as we have the games, and that's almost what it feels like to me, is like, Zelda will be ready March 3rd, so fuck it, here's the system.
yeah.
That's literally what this feels like to me, because when we get to the launch lineup, which they didn't explicitly go through, which kind of soured me a little bit, because I had to like spend like an hour digging through this to figure out what on earth was there at launch.
Yeah.
But again, like, it seems like Zelda comes out March 3rd. We don't have much else, but we know you want to play Zelda, and we know we can't release it on the Wii U 6 months before we're going to release it on the Switch, because nobody's going to buy it then, even though nobody probably would have bought it anyway knowing this was coming. But we'll get to that later. But anyway, so March 3rd, $300, which to me, $50 too high.
Yeah, this is like just out of impulse price.
Yes.
I mean, impulse price, like $200 is still not like a really impulse purchase, but it's definitely that's like, $300 is a lot to me. For whatever reason, I have that as like an expensive PS2. Like, because I remember PS2 was like $300 forever, and it was just sort of this unattainable thing. And now until it hit that $200 price point, which is like, oh, and then it exploded. But yeah, it feels like it's just outside whatever like that insta buy thing is, and that's okay. When this conference started, I was like, okay, this is okay because they're gonna bring it on software.
Yeah.
And they will. It's just not going to be at launch.
There's a build.
Yeah.
Build, not very, library.
Yeah, yeah.
But yeah, no, I think you're right. I think if this hit kind of, I mean, there were, I think $199, that was kind of a rumor that was floating around here and there. Yeah. I think that's just wholly unrealistic for what, you know, anything at this point in terms of a video game console, handheld, whatever you want to classify it as, that's just too low.
Yeah.
But I think that 250 range, that puts it, because I think PS4s and Xbox Ones are selling for 300 right now as well, correct?
I think that sounds right to me. Yeah.
So, I mean, I guess I think what Nintendo really needed to do is they need to come out $50 cheaper than the PS4 and Xbox One, even though you're the new thing, even though you've got the handheld console hybrid. I think you needed to come in $50 cheaper, just because at this point Nintendo, let's be honest, Nintendo has had a stigma since the Wii of A, the Wii developed this casual shovelware lineup thing, and the Wii U kind of developed this sense of there's no games and there's no third-party support. So I think the Wii has that stigma, or not the Wii, the Nintendo as a whole has that stigma, and I think that $50 would have, like you said, put it in that category where people go, I know what it is, but $250, I mean, it's only $250. Like, that's cheap. Like, come on. Like, it's cheap by comparison.
Yeah, it, actually, I'm looking at it now. It's PS4 is going for $280.
Yeah, so I mean,
this is
again,
more expensive than a PS4, which is dangerous.
Yeah, and I think for people like me and you who've been sitting here with a PlayStation 4, in my case with an Xbox One for years and months, like it's a different situation than a new entry into this generation of gaming. Mm-hmm. You know, somebody who is, you know, I'm picturing, you know, 20-year-old me who's going, you know what, I think it's finally time to make the jump, and I'm sitting here going, Switch 300. PS4 280, like, come on, you know what I mean? Like,
yeah,
but
and it's
anyway.
Like, and right now it's like, I mean, PS4 has a whole like plethora of games, and like Switch is just coming out with
Zelda.
Yeah with Zelda, and it's like and it's like I can see a lot of Zelda fans going, yeah, of course I'm gonna get it for Zelda, it's Zelda. But I mean, they did the same thing with Wii. Like, this is like literally the exact same thing.
Yeah.
And but, it's just like, yeah.
And as we get into the games here, I think a lot of this, they are really trying to hit hard on what succeeded for the launch of the Wii.
Yeah.
And looking through this as we go through it, 1-2 Switch is your Wii Sports. It's your grandma can pick this up and play it and will have a blast with it. ARMS is that Wii boxing. Like, okay, like, you want to start, like, getting into some real type of games. Like, this has some, you know, strategy and some thought to it. It's probably... It looks fantastic, by the way. Like,
yeah,
I'm
looks
pumped about
good.
That game. So I'm not trying to harp on that game, but I'm saying, like, that is your middle of the road, like, any, you know, it's not Street Fighter. You know what I mean? Like, I'm not gonna need to pick this up, learn a whole bunch, but it's something that anybody can kind of pick up and play, and after you play it for an hour or two, probably have the style of that down. So you've got those style games, and then you're launching with Zelda. And I think that's what the Wii really did, is the Wii got those people who just want this new thing where it's got these new kind of fun, cool, casual games, and you've got this big behemoth of a game, Zelda, which is kind of cool too. So
yeah, I want to talk about ARMS for a quick second, because that was an oddly neat game for some reason. For whatever reason, like, I think we both actually said this, like, it kind of looks like Power Stone.
Yeah, it's like, it looks like if you took Wii Boxing and Power Stone and kind of combined them together. And in my mind, this is why I'm still really excited about Nintendo's future, regardless of my overall thoughts on this, and regardless of, you know, it's launching week and it's maybe priced too high, is Nintendo kind of almost showed this to me with Splatoon and now with this, where it's Nintendo's getting back to the idea of, we need to innovate. We need to have new creative games. We can't just sit here and go, all right, Switch conference, throw out the Metroid, throw out the Mario, throw out the Zelda. Let's get Kirby up there. Let's get, you know, and go through the classic lineup. It's okay. You know what? You've got Mario, you've got Zelda. Splatoon is going to be in that category soon enough. And let's start getting a couple other things in there as well. So,
I mean, yeah. And I think ARMS is kind of an interesting one. I was surprised the 1-2 Switch and ARMS were like the first two Switch games we ever saw.
No,
we did see like the little bits, but like officially announced, like, here's these games. It was like kind of weird.
No, because Zelda's the first one. Zelda has been playing and been shown on Switch for months and months. So, I think what that was is them going, like, trying to go from, like, the hardware has a reason. I think that was one of the issues with the Wii U gamepad, is it never had a reason. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
Being somebody who bought a Wii U, not at launch, but within 3 or 4 months of launch, like, that gamepad never got used the way it was demonstrated, never got used the way that I think the designers of it thought through it originally. It was just there. This is them going, like, here are, out of the gate, two things that use these ideas we've put in here right away.
Mm. Yeah. And I think it's also with, like, the Wii U, there was that kind of question of, like, not like it's, like you're saying, it's like, what is this thing even for? And, like, right now we're like, oh, what is this thing even for? It's like, oh, well, I guess that's kind of cool, some of the stuff it can do. It does feel very Wii-like, though. Like, it feels like Wii 2, if that makes sense.
But really, that's what Nintendo needs, because the Wii U was like, I mean, again, to kind of go into those weird, like, numbering systems, you had the Wii, and then the Wii U is like that 1.5 system, I feel like, for Nintendo, where it's like, we're going to hold on to that, but we're going to kind of make something new with it, but this is still there. This is them just going full on, like, nope, this is our new thing, this is our new successor. And I think If you really think about Nintendo does build on what they've done. You know what I mean? You had the NES, you add a couple buttons for Super Nintendo. You take those buttons and now you put a joystick on it for Nintendo 64. You take it for GameCube, you add another joystick. You know what I mean? You're always just kind of adding that extra thing. So it is that build from the Wii, which is cool.
Yeah, it does actually feel like they were kind of addressing a lot of the complaints with both Wii and Wii U. Because Wii U is like, it's like, what's the point of the screen if I can't take it anywhere? Like, you couldn't even, you can't, I mean, like, I used it at your house. You can't take it even, like, in all areas of your house, which is kind of frustrating. But then with the Wii, the biggest complaint about the Wii was, like, this controller, man. I just want a traditional controller. So they released, like, the Pro Controller, and they kind of just try to do all these things to sort of, like, with the Wii, they just came up with, like, a million different things to try to fit everybody. And this thing already has all that stuff in it. So, like, it already has, like, it already comes with a normal control, normal-ish controller. Like, it's not a Pro Controller, but it's, like, you can smack them down into whatever the holder thing is. So you have, like, a
The
semi-normal controller.
Joy-Con grip.
The Joy-Con, oh God, whatever. The Joy-Con grip, but then you can pull it off, and then it's a Wiimote. I mean,
Yeah. And again, and I like the idea of being able to turn it sideways, and then it's not like a Wiimote, where the Wiimote never felt like a real controller. It felt like a TV remote with the three buttons, where you still have all the buttons on it, which I think was a big issue with the Wiimote, was you had to pare every game down to the point where it was playable with essentially three or four buttons. This is still gone. You still got your shoulders, you still got your four mains, you still got your analog stick. Obviously, you don't now have dual analog sticks, but for a lot of games that you can work around that more so than you could with the Wii, where you didn't even have an analog stick on your main controller. Some of the other things I'm very curious to see, because I will be getting this. I don't know if I will be getting this March 3rd or not. I'm still on the fence about that, but I will be getting this. Some of the interesting stuff to me too is the handheld thing, where it's like, okay, it is set up to be a handheld. I was a little bit, kind of interested to see how they played that off, as what part this handheld piece takes. But the idea of, okay, it still does have that connector I can take anywhere with me, and one of the accessories that they're selling is a car charger for it. So you do have all of these traditional handheld accessories bundled in there as well. And then again, that 2.5 to 6.5 battery life, which 2.5, I think they said Zelda's about 3 is what they were saying for Zelda, which makes sense. And then I'm assuming 6 is like you're playing, the
Nintendo
UI.
games or something.
Yeah, or NES games or whatever. So I mean, I think that's, for what this is and the power this thing's putting out, I think that's doable. And again, the fact that it has that car charger that, you can take it with you and plug it in, that to me is a big thing, just because, I mean, how often are you somewhere where you don't have access to an outlet? So,
I think it kind of actually reminds me of like a Super Vita, if that makes any
yeah.
sense.
That was kind of my feeling with it too.
Which is not a slight. We both actually, both of us, both own, we both own Vitas, and we both really like our Vitas. I think for me, like personally, it's just the Vita I really liked about it was that it had a bunch of indie games. I think 3DS had a lot as well, but like Vita just felt like every indie game I want to play, I could probably play on the Vita in some way, shape, or form. And just it had a bit more of the like adult games. It wasn't entirely just kid centric. And the Switch kind of looks like it's not just kid centric. Like it definitely doesn't feel like, I feel like the Wii U is sort of marketed to like really young families. It's just sort of marketed to, they're going for a broad audience, but I think they're doing something which I think Sony's actually done for a long time, is doing like a family console where it's not just for kids. It's not just for like it's not for young kids anymore. It is for like everybody. It's for people on the go sort of thing. And I actually like that. I think it's just a super powerful handheld system that is like designed with controllers. Is that's pretty neat. And I really do like all those like little like dumb things you can do, like your controller is splits into two controllers. Like that's a neat concept. I really like that.
Yeah, it is for sure. Because I mean, because there's so often that you're sitting there going like, oh yeah, I'm just sitting here playing this, and like, I mean, I've had it before with even my Vita, where I'm sitting like with somebody and it's like, oh yeah, like you should try, you know what I mean? It's just like, oh well, we can pass the Vita back and forth, and I was like, oh, you just pop that kickstand up and then I got mine, you got yours, let's go. Like it's those things where it's like Nintendo is making sense of their ideas, and it is, they're going, you know what, let's have a reason for everything. There's everything that I've seen with this seems justifiable in some way. Now, to every single person, is it going to be
I was
justifiable?
gonna say,
No, but there is someone somewhere for every, you know what I mean? Somebody's going to fit into each one of these things that they've done with it.
Actually, the one thing I'm super curious about, because it makes no effing sense as they had shown it, was the HD Rumble, which I can sort of understand. The one where like they show like
The
the
ice
glass,
cubes.
which is like, that's really kind of an interesting concept, but most of the games I play with a traditional controller, so I'm curious how that sort of translates over to a traditional controller.
Yeah, especially
I can
with
understand like holding like sort of like a controller size thing that sort of like you can it vibrates, you know, because your whole hand is grasping it. But when you're grasping it with like with your controller grip, I don't quite see how it works. I'm curious. I'm like excited for it, but it's just like that thing does. It seems like it does too much, but like it does.
Something's gonna
a lot
get overlooked. But again, like your Vita comparison is fairly apt there, where it's like
oh,
you got
true.
The microphone, you got the camera, you got the back touchpad, you got the front touchpad, you've got tilt sensors, you got all this stuff in there. So anyway, but let's hit some other games here that came up. So 1-2 Switch and ARMS, I think, are kind of their here's what it can do ones. But then they got into kind of their more okay, this is a more traditional gaming machine, and
yeah,
they went with Splatoon 2. Kind of was one of the first kind of more traditional style games you had, which. I freaking love Splatoon, so even if this is just, I mean, it kind of just sounded like new maps, new weapons, you know, that kind of, I don't want to say like 1.5, but it felt like 1.5 as they were talking about it.
I think we were watching it together, we were sitting there typing back and forth to each other, but like, I think you weren't even quite sure if it was Splatoon 2.
Like, yeah, no, I wasn't. As I was watching it, I wasn't. It was one of those things where I'm like, I know these are all new things, but like, it still has that look and that feel, and it doesn't seem like it's that next step. It seems like it's just like, you know what? We took it, we redid a whole, we did redid everything, and here it is. Which to me is, again, it's fine. Like Splatoon was, I mean, that is a perfect, one of those perfect games in my mind. That was, whatever year that came out, that was my favorite game that year.
Yeah.
That is, you know, tons of great memories of Splatoon. So if that's all it is, that's totally good with me. Mm-hmm. And that to me is, again, one of those reasons where it's like, this is a game, and this is what Nintendo does well, I think, is this is a game that I can only play there. There's nothing else really like it, and I have to have this to buy it or to play
but,
it. So
I mean, you've played a lot of Splatoon. Like, are you excited to play it? I know it's Splatoon 2, but I mean, even you're saying, like, you're just saying it's kind of like Splatoon 1.5. Like, are you excited to get back into Splatoon again?
Oh, hell
so
yeah.
Quickly?
If it was Splatoon, okay. If it was literally just, we remade Splatoon and now it's $30 on the Switch, I'd be like, that's enough reason for me to play Splatoon again for 40 hours.
Oh, okay, yeah, no, I was just curious. I know I've heard it's a good game. I haven't played it though, so yeah.
Oh, so good.
Yeah, I think, and then kind of the same tune, Mario Kart 8 Deluxe Edition, which is it's not the same tune, but like the Mario Kart 8 Deluxe, which is like Mario Kart 8 with just a bunch of extra stuff. I'm excited for this because I haven't played these games on Wii U, but you already have a Wii U. So do these I'm surprised these announcements still kind of. They seem to matter to you?
The only one that doesn't matter to me, looking through the list, in terms of, like, Nintendo games, because obviously, like, Skyrim I don't care about, like, that kind of stuff, and, you know, and some of the Dragon Quest things that you can get wherever, like, those things aren't as huge, but the thing to me that are big are the new things. And Mario Kart, I'm not a huge Mario Kart fan, like, I buy every single Mario Kart, but it's one of those things that I play through all the different tracks once and, you know, mess around a little bit online, and then I move on. It's not something that, like, holds my attention for days and days like Splatoon does.
Oh, okay, yeah.
So that's kind of my tempered reaction to Mario Kart is going, you know what? If that came out and it was $30, I'd probably buy it, but I'm not paying $60 again for Mario Kart.
Yeah.
I just, it's not my thing. It's great. It's awesome. They're great games. I love them, but it's not something I need to go back and play, where Splatoon is something that I would.
Yeah, you know, actually, I just stay on Mario Kart for a quick second. I think that is one of those games that would, like, be immediately, that controller swap where they can have, like, you can give your controller to someone else sort of thing.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
That would be super fun to play Mario Kart on a plane or something with somebody next to you.
Oh, like, yeah. Or just, like, you know, all the Christmas stuff I did over the past, like, 2 weeks, just having that with me and just being like, oh, my gosh, I'm sick of sitting here talking to my family over and over again or whatever. Like, oh, my gosh, so much smaller. Let's just play Mario Kart. Here you go. You know what I mean? Like, it is that cool thing. But again, I think that's where there's two different audiences for this. I think there's the audience like me who, like, has bought every Nintendo console since I have been able to buy video game consoles.
Yeah.
And then there's people who, you know, yeah, I've played these games and I'm excited for more of them. But then I also feel like there's this audience like you where it's these people who have missed out on the Wii U. And the Wii U, as flawed of a system as it is, as an unpopular system as it was, there are some fantastic games on there that really deserve a bigger audience than they got. And Mario Kart 8 is one of them. The Donkey Kong Tropical Freeze. They announced a new Xenoblade Chronicles X. Like, if those games are there, do you know what? Remaster those and put them out on the Switch once the Switch has an install base.
Yeah.
Those games are going to fly off shelves. They're so good. And there are so many people like you who are into games who just, I'm not going to buy a Wii U for these specific six games when I'm not already a big Nintendo fan.
Yeah, yeah, and I was, it's that sort of like double-edged sword. Like, I kind of hope they would announce more and announce less.
Yeah.
Because you don't want it to be too many where it's like, what is the, is this just a Wii U and then, or announce too little, and then it's like, where's all the Wii U games?
Yeah, and I am curious to see how that comes, because I think this would have been a poor place to go. And you get Mario Kart 8 remastered, and they didn't even, you know, that wasn't even put on the stage show at all, outside of just in a couple of, like, you know, montage videos.
Yeah, that was and super weird.
What, that it wasn't there?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, they just kept, like, showing it without saying anything about it?
Well, yeah, like, there was just no official trailer for it until everything was done. That was just weird.
Yeah, but again, I think that's one of those things where that's intentional of going, there were rumors that this thing was going to launch with Splatoon 1.5, Zelda, which is also a Wii U game, Mario Kart 8, which is a Wii U game, and I think that was intentional to go, no, this isn't just a updated Wii U. Those things may come, which I hope they do, but that's not going to be our focal point with it.
Yeah. I just would like to see that list sooner rather than later.
I agree completely. That would have been a great thing to just throw out this morning in a treehouse or whatever, which I haven't had a chance to watch, so I don't even know what came out on the treehouse this morning either. But
yeah.
Anyway, the big one.
the only one. Sorry.
No.
Yeah, yeah.
Xenoblade 2, No More Heroes, Zelda, come on now, don't be a jerk. Mario, Super Mario Odyssey.
Holy shit.
That literally nothing I could say would be better than that.
Yeah, that I don't know how you can play video games. It doesn't, if you're like the deepest Xbox fan or the deepest PlayStation, I don't know how you couldn't look at that and be like just a little bit excited for it. That looks awesome. It's Mario, it's like Mario 64 2 or yeah. Sunshine 2,
because I mean this is the game I've been waiting for since Super Mario Sunshine, and they keep going back to, oh well, we're gonna go 2D, you know, we're gonna go 2.5D, and it's just one of those things where, and even Galaxy is an amazing game,
yeah,
but just having that whole world and just having these big open spaces and just the environments that you saw in that, just everything, just, it's one of those games that as I was looking, I was like, if in my mind, if that's a Switch game, or not a Switch game, a launch game, this thing, if you launched that in Zelda,
oh yeah, yeah, yeah,
this thing would have flew, oh my god, like this would have been fastest selling console ever, because that just, it looks so good. Like, that's one of those things where I think I watched that trailer a dozen times, because I just like, what is this? Like,
it definitely gave me pause, because I was like, I might get a Switch. Like, I mean, yeah. I was kind of like the, you know, show, I'm curious what this thing is. I'm just like here to learn sort of thing before I think about it. But like, you know, when they show that Mario trailer, it is so that game that people have been talking about forever.
Yep.
Doesn't like, well, wouldn't it be cool if your Mario could jump around a city like in Grand Theft Auto, which is a dumb thing to say, but it's something that people have thought about for sure.
Oh yeah, for sure.
And
there it is.
About, people have talked about.
Yeah. So I don't necessarily want to run through any of these games. A couple of the other ones that stood out to me.
Wait, are we done with Mario?
Dude, I literally don't know what else to say. Like, I don't even know what to say about Mario, like, other than, like, that thing looks amazing.
Dude, I could talk about Mario forever, because the one thing I liked besides just the city stuff was, I like that it wasn't just a city. It's like, okay, there's Mario jumping around a city. It's like, oh, but now there's Mario jumping around an abandoned jungle with robot teapots and a Mexican village with sphinxes running around and... some weird food world that looks like some like weird low poly. I don't like, this game was just like nothing. I, in my wildest dreams, it's not something I could have thought up of. And it's one of those things that we've been talking about where it seems like these big franchises are taking big chances. And I really appreciate that. I think that's really cool and coming through.
Yeah. And I think that in seeing that in Zelda, with both of them going in just wholly new directions that you've never seen before from these franchises.
Yeah.
I'm very curious to see where Nintendo starts to go with their other big ones.
Yeah, like what happened to Metroid or Star Fox
Donkey Kong, all that stuff, where it's like, what are you going to do now with these other games, these other characters you have sitting there, where, I mean, they took a risk with Metroid Prime, that paid off substantially,
yeah.
You know, but Donkey Kong's always been the same, and Star Fox, you know, has been Star Fox 64 since Star Fox 64, like... with subtle variations on it, and of course, yeah,
yeah.
You know what I'm saying. But yeah. Anyway, but now to see that, okay, we're willing to take a chance with our characters now. We're not just sticking them in there. This is a Mario game, and every Mario game is going to conform to these six things. And this is Zelda, and Zelda needs to have this. But now it's like, Link doesn't even have the outfit anymore. Like, yeah. You know, and yeah. Mario's in a city with people. You know, you've got all these different things where it's like, okay, we're going to take chances now, and we're going to try and innovate a little bit more, and with not only with our hardware side, but with our software side as well.
Yeah, and I really hope that carries through to the other franchises. Like, I want to see what the Breath of the Wild version is for Metroid. Actually, what I'm real talk, Kirby. Like, holy shit. If they, like, reinvent Kirby, I'm going to be very excited.
you do love your Kirby. But, I don't know, it's one of those things that, like, I really don't even want to sit here and talk about it, because just go watch the trailer. Like, the trailer is better than anything I can say about it. And
yeah.
Me talking about how great it is not going... And again, maybe this is just me as somebody who's played Mario since, you know, I was 5 years old.
Yeah.
But there is something very different about just seeing that trailer and just watching it over and over again. And I think if somebody tried to explain to me what that trailer was and tell me why they're excited about it, I'd be like, that makes no sense. And then you sit down and you watch and you're just like, oh my God. Like,
yeah. This
isn't real. Like, this, there's no way you're doing this right now.
And it's weird, because I think Mario was one of those innovative franchises, and it just isn't anymore.
Yeah. I mean, Galaxy did some cool things.
Yeah.
But when you compare that with some of the things that you saw before with Super Mario World, and even, you know, of course, the NES classics, which predate me a little bit. I wasn't, you know, I hadn't played them, but, you know, obviously not so much at the time. But, and then Mario 64, and then Sunshine, and seeing where these things took that genre. And then you kind of just had that... I don't even want to say contentment, but that's almost what it felt like. We're content with Mario being this.
Yeah, I think since even Mario Galaxy 1, because 2 was great, but it's just Mario Galaxy 2.
Yeah.
It's just they've been coasting since then.
I think coasting's a bit harsh. I think they've just been, because they've been good games. Like, Super Mario 3D World on the Wii U is fantastic, but it's that coasting. It's just that contentment.
Yeah.
I guess I just used the same word you did, so I guess that's okay. Anyway, I like Mario, and I liked all those games. But anyway... Yeah, it's so good. But anyway, so are we good to move on from Mario? Like I said, like I don't even know where to go with that. Some other games here. Xenoblade 2.
Oh my god.
I never played the original Xenoblade, but I played Xenoblade Chronicles X. And I know I think this is supposed to be a sequel to the first one, the Wii one, and then the Wii U one is like a separate thing. I don't really know how these things all go together in that universe, but I just know that, oh my god, I want to play that game.
That honestly, like, when I saw that trailer, I was like, I need to play I've thought about playing the first one, and then I was like, I need to play this game, and I need to get the context from the first one. Like, I thought I need to play the first game. Like, I never had that feeling before. And when I saw that giant thing, like that opening shot of that giant, like massive, like the largest thing I think I've ever seen, just like moving, I was like, I need to play this. Like, there was no question in my mind. I was like, that's one of the games I will get a Switch for sure.
Yeah, and I think that's the thing with this, and we'll talk about it, I think, maybe even a little bit more at the end after we've kind of talked about more of these. This thing has a crazy good lineup. It's just spread out over the course of the year. This is, I think, Nintendo realizing with the Wii U, they did, like, one or two games a year and tried to sell it on that and going, like, no, we need a bunch, because this is a 2017 game. Mario is a 2017 game. Splatoon 2 is a 2017 game. Zelda is a 2017 game. They're just spaced out at, like, two-month intervals.
Yeah, and honestly, like, I'll have a Switch by this time next year, but I probably won't buy it till this time next year.
Yeah, and I think that'll be the curious point I honestly think that's going to be good for Nintendo sales-wise, because I think you're going to get the boost right away from the Zelda people, and then 2 months later, you get, I don't remember what came out, you get Splatoon, and you're going to get the boost from all the people who played Splatoon 1 on the Wii U and are loving it, and all the people who are like you, who it's like, I'm getting this eventually, you know what, Splatoon 2 might as well be my jumping on point.
Mario Kart's getting a lot of people, too.
Yeah, and then again, you get Mario in the fall or winter, and that's going to jump on a whole bunch of people. And Xenoblade's it's going to be this slow build of people, where every month or two you have this game that people are going to say, that is the game that I need this for.
Yeah, I think Skyrim probably will even get some people, weirdly. Not me. I'm not saying I'm just saying, but like there's got to be an audience for that.
The only thing I can think of at this point is there's some Skyrim people are going, you know what? I'd love to be able to just walk around and play Skyrim. That's the only thing I can see this with, is this essentially Skyrim handheld. That's the only thing I see this as being.
Yeah.
That's the only reason I see this justified here, is that there are people who love Skyrim, and just the thought of being able to bring Skyrim around with them is huge for these people. And that's not me. I'm very much for Bethesda, I'll put my 20-25 hours in and we'll call it a day.
Like, but every RPG you play.
No, hey, no, that's rude. Most, but not all.
That's true.
But anyway, but yeah, so Xenoblade's there. That's gonna be awesome. There's some other stuff kind of thrown in here. I don't know if there's any of the stuff you really want to talk about, but it's a lot of that stuff where it's like, if I had a Switch, I'd play that. Like the Fire Emblem Warriors. If I had a Switch, I'd play that.
It was actually my impression was a lot of like, this is gonna take a while for some of the stuff to come out. The Shin Megami one is like such a
oh, that was like literally like an engine, like, we have an engine and it runs on the Switch. Here you go. I don't even think they announced the title. I think it was just something in this universe.
Yeah, and then they showed like the Yakuza guy come out and said like, hey, we're gonna make a thing. And then Suda 51 was like, hey, we're gonna make a thing. It's like, this is a cool console. Like, everything I heard about is like, this is pretty neat. It's just like, this should have come out like later. Like, March is like too soon for a lot of this stuff.
Yeah, we should have held off on it. But new No More Heroes is huge. Like, I'm a big I love No More Heroes. So, and everything Suda 51 touches is fantastic to me. And so I'm pumped about that. And again, that'll be probably, I think they said they started working out last year, so that'll probably be a end of next year game, maybe a holiday 2018.
Sure.
But yeah, so a lot of other stuff. I don't know if there's anything else in here that you're super all about talking about. I think the rest of it's just kind of there.
Yeah, I think the rest of it was just kind of like, honestly, like, I was trying to think of the conference, like, if it didn't have Mario and, like, the stuff I just was not that interested in. Like, because I think, like, coming off, like, oh, this is a lot of new shiny stuff. But I was like, if this was announced in E3, would I care? Not too much. Like, Splatoon, I thought Splatoon 2 looked really cool. I really love that art style. I thought some of these games looked pretty kind of neat, but like it didn't feel like a bombastic besides Mario. Like, Mario was just like, that's just another level. It didn't feel like those big shocking announcements. Like, when PS4 was announced, like, they showed Infamous and Shadowfall, and while those didn't turn out to be great games, like, at the time, like, that was incredible. Like,
they felt big.
Yeah. And this one, it's just like, oh, Mario looks awesome. You know what I mean? Like, Mario seems big. Like, I'll give you Mario, but...
Now, again, like, you're speaking about this from somebody who's not a Nintendo person. Like, to me, like, I'm looking at this list, like, 1-2 Switch, as weird as it is, like, being all in on the Wii and the Wii U, there were some weird games like that that are amazing that will, like, occupy you for hours on end, and that's one of them. Yeah. Same thing with ARMS. Like, those two games alone, like, got me pretty pumped. Like, Splatoon 2, there's a good chance that will be my game of the year this year. not gonna lie, like, I love those games that much. Mario is huge. Xenoblade 2 is huge. Like, I'm not super into Fire Emblem and the whole Warriors thing. I'm not super into that, but there are people who that is a killer game for.
I guess that's true.
Dragon Quest is a big thing. Again, I've always sided more on the, like, Final Fantasy side when it comes to JRPGs. That's normally my go-to, so I haven't played much Dragon Quest, but that's huge for people. You know what I mean? So these things, again, you're in a headspace where these are not your thing. You grew up as a PlayStation person.
I guess,
you
know, that's what I mean? True. Yeah.
So very different perspectives. Like, to me, like, if this was at E3, this is a great conference still. Now, is it Sony good? No. But is it great? Yes.
And
of course, the last one, we've hinted at a couple times, but Zelda came out, had a new trailer, launch game. I don't think there's anything really new to talk about that, except it is 13.2 gigabytes. The Switch's internal memory at launch is 32.
How are you talking about? Oh, God. I don't even want to get into this. Like,
I don't either, but I just need to point out that Zelda will take up about half of your Switch internal hard drive day one.
Speaking of being like Vita, oh, my gosh.
Yes. Yeah, go with your memory cards. Although, I don't think you have to buy the Nintendo ones. Like, you can use anyone you want. Yeah, you don't run into Sony charging $90 for a $20 card.
But that's the thing, like when I think of it, it's like, oh, okay, it's $300, but it's actually $300 plus 128 gig card, which is, you know, actually like another $40 or $50 plus a game, so that's actually not $500. You know what I mean?
Maybe. It's that slow build of money, and if you want a pro controller, which I will, that's another $70. And again, like, if you do want a proper Joy-Con too, I think the Joy-Con, like, you get the two Joy-Cons and the grip, I think that's another $80. So there's... And that is with anything, like, we talked about that with even with, like, VR, you need to get the camera, you need to get the Move, you need to get, you know, all that stuff. And then we talk about it when you get a new system. Okay, you got to get two controllers, you got to get the game, you got to pay for the online service, which is there too. But, But anyway, I think that's kind of a good place to wrap it up. I mean, so where are you at with this? Where is your, because you've cut a couple times, like sometime through this year, like what's going to be the domino that gets pushed over that's going, Doug has a Switch now?
Mario. That Mario game looks sick. Like there's like honestly like I don't know. I mean people have been listening. I know you know the type of games I like. Like I don't have like strong opinions of Mario, but like that struck like a lot of the right buttons for me.
Yes,
And I've
absolutely.
been dying to play like just a good 3D platformer, and I feel like those have really gone by the way. I mean Ratchet and Clank was a good one, but even that was like I've played this before. I
Yeah,
think
it's
that
really Mario and Ukulele are the only two I can even think about come out this year.
Yeah, and this looks way that looks way better than ukulele.
Yeah, I
Sorry.
agree. I agree.
Yeah.
Ukulele is that awesome, like that's that like it's that nostalgia-y 3D platform versus
Yeah.
like here is the true what a 2017 platformer should be.
Yeah, and I think that'll be it 'cause that game just looks too interesting to but really to me it's just waiting 'cause like I don't see anything from here until then that's going to make me go ooh and because I just don't like Zelda that much.
Yep.
And to me Zelda seems like the only one. And all the other games I was like I would rather non-Nintendo games. It's like there's no way I'd just rather play on PS4. Like there's not
Yeah.
many. Maybe JRPGs. I think JRPGs would be good on Switch, but like most of the other ones I'd be like I'd rather just play them on PS4.
And I can see that because I kind of feel the same way of going, you know what, like, and I think that's what Nintendo consoles, you need to understand that that's what they are, is a Nintendo console is for Nintendo games. Back in the day, you go back to the GameCube and then Nintendo 64, then yeah, okay, you know what, that can be your console, that is your main console that you're playing every third party on, you're playing everything on. But at this point, I think Nintendo is settling into that niche of going like, we are here for these games, for these types of games, for our games. We will have other people's games here. If you buy our system, you can still play them, you can still get those experiences, but we're not gonna sell Switches off Call of Duty. We're not going to sell Switches off Madden. We're going to try and sell Switches off FIFA, but that's still just kind of thrown in there because we know people like soccer.
Yeah, but honestly, but that's what I'm saying. Like, it feels like they didn't turn change their tune enough. Like, it does feel like the Wii U is an excellent console for Nintendo games. It's not for other ones because honestly, like, ours, you're gonna buy multi-platforms for other consoles,
Yeah,
unless
especially if
it's
you
like
have them, yeah.
just depending on the genre. I think there's some genres that actually work really well handheld, like JRPGs, like I was saying,
Yeah,
but.
and that's the thing that will be in the back of my mind the whole time is going when there are those games, which will be few and far between. I think like a lot of them are going to be those JRPGs, those indie games, those types of things where you're going to have PS4 versus Switch option. That handheld aspect I think could end up playing a role in it for me of going, you know what? Like for the most part, my video game consoles are in my basement. I've got my big TV set up. I got them all plugged in there. If I'm going to go sit upstairs and do something with my wife, like I can just grab this and take it up there with me. You know what I mean? And that alone to me is going like, okay, well then maybe I do get, you know, one of those smaller indie games, one of those, whatever it may be. I Am Setsuna is a launch game. Like that's a game I still haven't played. That's one that would fit perfectly on the idea of a Switch for me of going like, I'm just playing it. Like, okay, I'm gonna go do this now and take this with me.
So I mean, yeah, I'm excited. I just want to wait. That's pretty much it. Like I don't even really have a negative reaction to this. Even some of the bad news coming out of it, it's like, that software like really like Zelda and Mario's pretty solid. I'm just curious what they're gonna start doing with their other like franchises.
Yeah, for sure. So, eventually for you, sometime before the end of the year.
Maybe. We'll
Nice.
see.
Cool. Well, I think that'll pretty much wrap it up. So, we will probably be talking about this more as it comes out over the next couple months and as more and more kind of slowly. I feel like Nintendo's been just slowly dripping information out all day long since last night. So, I'm sure that'll continue over the next couple months. But I'm pumped for it. I'm 50-50 on my pre-order.
I
It
am
literally,
patient.
literally from about 11 p.m. last night till now, I think I've probably gone and checked pre-orders like 8 times and gone, I probably shouldn't.
I think you've already like lost. I don't. I think you.
I totally have, but like that, like in my mind of like, I'm gonna buy that day one, and I was like, no, no, you're not. Don't be
No,
stupid.
you're
You don't want to play Zelda that bad, and then going, you're right, I don't. Oh, but I
not.
really want one. So, but
Yeah.
anyway, we are Workforce Gaming. Subscribe to us here. Follow us on Twitter at Workforce Gaming. Comment on stuff. What are your thoughts on the Switch? Did this do anything for you? Are you moved to buy it? Are you pushed away from it? Let us know and we can comment and such. I don't know. I feel like I was doing a really good job at that and then I totally lost steam. Anyway, we'll see you
All
later.
right, see you guys.